how often are patients coming in to in through your doors with head injuries?
In the emergency department, every day. I don't think there's a shift when you don't see a head injury.
And Jennifer,
up from the emergency room, they do come up and sometimes they require a 24-hour stay just for close observation to make sure that there's no issues and no concerns or anything that we have to be worried about with a concussion afterwards.
Absolutely.
But we do see them quite a bit.
Now, Doctor, can I call you Dr. T?
Absolutely.
Okay, I like Dr. T. What are the most common fall? Are they falls? Are they banging their head against something? Or is it like a sport injury? What are the most common head injuries you're seeing in the ER?
The most frequent cause is a fall. Okay. By far. You also see head injuries from banging into a wall or a motor vehicle collision. Rarely, thank goodness, from penetrating injuries like bullets.
Right.
Sports injuries are common, let's just say, especially in the older children and teenagers.
Right. Now for little ones, and Jennifer, you can speak to this as well. I'm a mom of two kids, 6 and 3. We've fallen off the bed, the changing table, all those things. Are those common when the kids fall off the bed and the head injuries happen?
They are. There's one that we call the Saturday morning injury. You know, the parents are tired from a long week at work.
Right.
The child, the infant is crying in the middle of the night, 3 a.m. They bring them to their bed. And 6 a.m. they fall, and they come to the ER.
That sounds familiar. Yes. And so they fall into two categories, the head injuries. And what are those two categories that they fall in?
Roughly external and internal.
Okay. And what does that mean? Just to...
Internal ones would happen around the meninges or the brain, and external outside the scalp and down to the bone.
Okay, I want to talk about something called goose eggs. I just learned this today, and I had no idea that's what it was called. So can you explain goose eggs?
Sure. Goose eggs are exactly what they sound like. It's a big swelling, usually typically in the middle of the forehead, and it comes from, that's it. And it's bruised like those pictures. They do get bruised because there are some blood that accumulates underneath.
Right.
And typically it's when kids fall head first.
Right.
Their heads are, especially for younger children, their heads are pretty heavy. So they kind of lead with their head, they fall, they hit their forehead, and that's what you get is the goose egg.